action!
Lean into the camera. Put your face right up to the camera.
It's about the essence of consciousness, what it is to be alive.
Go down from Dr. Lepage to Little Mermaid.
Good.
It's so inspiring and so original. And there's so much poetry in it.
It's such a positive film. It's a film full of hope.
I was really thinking about what film I wanted to make, and I received this script called The Diving Bell and the Butterfly, and it was really the kind of story I would want to tell.
It first came to me through Kathleen Kennedy, the producer. I started to work on it and I was very stuck. And I thought I better give her the money back. And I was about to call her to say, no, I can't do it, when this idea came to me that Jean-Dominique Bobby should be the camera and the camera should blink. So it would take the audience into his experience of locked-in syndrome.
And once he had that, then he knew exactly how he was going to tell the story. And I think that's what comes across in the movie so profoundly, is that you sit down and you immediately think, oh my God, I don't think I can do this. I don't think I can watch the story, from this kind of a claustrophobic feeling. And then it broadens out very quickly.
Through his imagination and his memory, he could escape. So to me, as a filmmaker, it sort of said, hey, you could put anything you want into this movie. Whatever comes to this guy's mind is possible.
I sat down with Julian for about 5 or 6 hours in our first meeting, and it was clear that Julian was very, very passionate about how he would approach telling the story. And Julian, right off the bat, said, I really want to do the movie in French.
I felt like it was very important for this movie to be told in a French voice. I mean, it was a French author, it was a French man that this thing happened to. He was in a French hospital, and I don't think I could have done it somewhere else.
When you add the French language and all of its poetry and this music that it really becomes, I think that all helps to create a world that you can kind of feel good about in the middle of all of this heartbreak.
E-S-A-R-R. Mourir. Vous voulez mourir.
Julian wanted to do it in French because I think he wanted to shoot where the real story happened, in this hospital at Berck-sur-Mer.
I went to the hospital and worked with people that were actually Jean Doe's nurses and assistant nurses and therapists and people that knew him, and went to the place where he sat on the terrace and got to see what the landscape looked like out there.
And I saw that the tide goes out 500 meters and comes back in, so I saw that happening, and I thought, okay, I'll stick him on this wheelchair and put him in the middle of this stanchion in the water. That wouldn't have happened if I wasn't there.
So I carried him on my shoulders out there.
Julian loves the water. He would jump in there no matter what the weather was, the colder the better. So once the crew sees the director out there doing it, it just inspires everybody to roll up their sleeves and jump in. I think with Julian as a director, he trusts his own instincts so much that he will get involved and then step by step find his way through and find material to use that day, things to inspire the actors. The hospital room became one more of Julian's kind of handmade paintings. There were a lot of different elements that Julian would place and position piece by piece to create this handmade quality, and a room that had a feeling of comfort and home and family and love, and just have it as almost another character in the film.
Yeah, that's very interesting.
What's interesting about working with Julian is that he's an artist first, and he's interested in creating a world that by all means is different from what we expect. That's a great freedom. He's just a really Renaissance man.
I think that Julian's art, he deals with layers of things, and I think he saw an opportunity to actually carry what he did on canvas into cinema.
Stay with the actor. The actor's gonna do everything.
It's never your turn to act. It doesn't work like that. We were all together with the crew. And he tries to get the best out of everybody.
Julian is a very warm, very generous person. And I understood at an early stage that there was something in his life in the film.
When I think about doing anything, I try to do something that means something to me.
So I made the movie for my father because he was scared to die and I wanted to help him.
Je suis terrifié.
Par quoi?
À l'idée que tu me rases.
Oh.
Julian brings a lot of personal elements to everything he does. And every time I watch the shaving scene and see Matthew grab Max and pull his ears and squeeze his cheeks, it's just what Julian used to do with his dad. It's such a beautiful scene, but it's just exactly like that bond that Julian had with his father.
Je suis très fier de toi. Vraiment. Je suis très fier.
It's just a moment of life, and in the film, it's so moving because they are not aware that they are living a special moment. That's why I just asked the props man to put me a real blade, so I would be afraid just to cut him. That's what I was concentrating on, not on how it's moving, no emotion, just, I'm gonna cut the throat of Max von Sydow. It's an idol for me.
I think Max really responded to the script. He has said many times that it's the best thing he's read in many, many years.
It was not difficult to do this character because it was all in the text. On est dans le même bateau. Moi, je suis coincé dans cet appartement. Je ne peux pas monter ou descendre les escaliers. Essaye un peu de descendre quatre étages.
The most wonderful thing is the intelligence and brilliance of Matthew Almerich. I don't know how he does it. He said he didn't really have to be an actor, he had to be a human being. But he may be a human being, but he's a hell of an actor.
At one point, it was a bit like if I was the journalist in Citizen Kane trying to understand who is this man, you know? And each person that we could meet that knew him would say something different on him. It wasn't a saint anymore. It was just a man with all the complexity.
Matthew is a great actor and he's a great person too. He gives you a lot of attention and I think it's because he's a director too. He's a great guy.
I prepared myself like a sportsman, you know, for it was a very physical part, in fact, because not to move when you can move demands the work of all your muscles, because you have to tense all your muscle not to move. If you are relaxed, it doesn't work. So I was all day long like that.
E-S-A-R-I-N-T-T. E-E. Chaque jour, je t'attends. Il a dit chaque jour je t'attends.
One of my favorite French actresses is Emmanuelle Seigner, and she gave this extraordinary performance in a movie called Bitter Moon that her husband Roman Polanski made, and I was a huge fan of that performance, and so I felt like it was a great opportunity that I was going to have to work with her.
Emmanuelle Seigner just breaks my heart. I think she puts us in the shoes of somebody who has to experience this for the first time and trying to hold it together.
The character I'm playing was not easy because it's very complex. She's a woman that has been left by that man 6 months before the accident with three kids. And it's between the revenge and the pity. And I didn't want her to be bitter, but I didn't want her at the same time to be a saint. So it was finding with Julian the right emotion.
Elle est venue? Elle est pas venue? Je croyais qu'elle était folle amoureuse de toi. De toute façon, ça la regarde.
I met her and she called me after she saw the film and she was crying like she couldn't talk and she told me thank you for me and the kids. So for me it was the best compliment and I thought that I didn't betray the family. So it's always very fulfilling.
ESARINTULOMDPCC. Merci. Merci.
I had seen Marie-José Cross in the Barbarian Invasions, and I thought she was extraordinary in that. So I knew that I wanted her to be in the movie.
When I prepared that character, I met the real person I played in the film. And she talked to me about the relationship she had with Jean-Dominique Bobby and how she do her work as a speech therapist. She has a heart like that. She's completely devoting to the patients and she feels what they feel. So the character, Henriette's character, is her. So I just had to understand the meaning of the girl.
Il y a des gens qui vous aiment, pour qui vous comptez. Moi, je vous connais à peine et vous comptez déjà beaucoup pour moi.
I think at some moment John Doe felt like he was selected, like it was a special thing that happened to him, and he made the most of it.
I think what makes it such a universal story is that people want to believe that if anything like that ever happened to them, that they would have the ability to still have the kind of outlook on life that John Doe did. He allowed himself to remain optimistic. And I think that's what people carry with them when they see the film.
All the little obstacles that we have in our everyday life, we shouldn't complain about this. We should try to continue. We should try to overcome. And he certainly does it in an extraordinary way.
It shows how human beings can be loving and empathetic. He was a man who couldn't do anything, couldn't take a bath, couldn't get a fly off of his nose. But the kind of warmth and compassion that people had for him, what that brings out in people is something that we shouldn't forget.